Hi everybody, this is Blossom, and today I want to show you two fairy oracles. Now we have the Faeries Oracle and we have the Heart of Faerie Oracle, both with the artwork of Brian Froud. But however, the text for the guidebook are two different people. And here we have the text by Jessica Macbeth, and here we have the text by Wendy Froud. So for me in this deck, there is a big difference in the guidebook, and I want to show you the differences in the guidebook and also in the cards, how the cards feel, because maybe you are at a point where you want to decide which deck to choose, and I think this is a really hard decision. So I try to show you both decks a bit in general. I don't think I will do a whole walkthrough because that will take forever for both decks, but at least to show you some differences. I want to show you the cards now, how they are categorized. In the first row, we can see the categories of the Faeries Oracle. And the second row is the Heart of Faeries. So we have more categories in the Heart of Faeries Oracle. However, let's start with the first one. Here we have the Singers of the Realm. They are the singers of the underlying songs of the universe. They are the great ones, the ones who show us what we have, the potential to ultimately become. They also help us to move in that direction and comfort us when we fall off the path. Now for me, and this is again me, the singers, when I think about the Cimmerillion, they're also, the world is created by song, by sound, and they sing the creation of the world. And for me, this is kind of similar when I see the singers here in this realm. Then we move on to the She, that is the second pile that we can see here. And the She are the people of the hills, the lords and ladies of faerie. They are the old ones. All faeries dance, but the She do so to meditate the powerful energies of the singers and to bring them into manifestation throughout the worlds. So that's what they say about the She. And then we come to the third pile. And there we have the fairy guides and guardians. So the guardians and the guides are those who devote time and energy to directly guiding humans as we develop our special talents and gifts and our own natural magic. They help us to become more than we already are, exploring our potentials and transcending our self-imposed limitations and fears. And so on. I'm just reading little examples so that you know where we are at. Where we are. And then we come to another category, and those, hopla, this is the helpline troop. These are the wee folk of faerie, large and small, who sometimes assist us in our daily lives and sometimes add more than a little to the confusion, usually in an effort to be helpful. These fairies are associated with the five elements, earth, air, fire, water, and moonlight. Some of them work singly and some are trooping fairies. And then the last category, the last pile, there we have the fairy challengers. The fairy challengers brings us face to face with our fears, our denials, our inner traumas, our insecurities, our delusions and confusions, and our misbehavior. These are the fairies who, metaphorically speaking, stick out a foot in front of us to see if we are paying attention to where we are going. So there you see, those are the categories for the Faeries Oracle, and the other ones you can see here. So first we have the Faerie Queens. Their advice can be loving, but it can occasionally be harsh, but they are always empowering figures. And the second pile, or second category of those, is the Queen Consorts. They are the balancing male energies that complement the Queens. They are 9 consorts, each of whom is a different aspect of male-female relationships. And by this I mean male-female energy, not necessarily gender. So this is important to know, I guess. Then we come to the archetypes. There are 13 archetypes in this deck. These are the ancient energies of fairy. They are the original inhabitants of this realm who have not changed from millennia to millennia. And then we come to the sprites. And there are 8 sprites in this deck. And those are more young, joyful spirits who provide help and encouragement. As we move on, we come to the ladies. And there are 6 ladies. They differ from the queens in that they are more personal and can be more temperamental. They reveal good intentions and highlight things we may need to address in ourselves before we can move on to greater understanding. And then we come to the tricksters. These are just what their title says. They have wisdom to impart, but it's going to come in an unexpected form and you may not like it. And the last pile is about the journey. So there are 16 journey cards. These cards also stand for the stages in life's journey and will give insight into where the reader stands on this journey, depending on the cards drawn and where they appear in a reading. So there you can at least see, you know, the differences in how they are categorized. And let's take a closer look at while I'm zooming. Now, as you can see, we have different borders. This is the older deck, the Faeries Oracle, and it's I don't really like the border on these cards, but it's okay. It's not awful, but it could have been better, to be honest. Sorry about the glare. It's way too neat for the energy of the deck as well. I prefer this border because it's more blended in with the rest and it's not so neat, it's not so exact. This actually, it should be just the other way around. I will talk about the energy of the deck a bit later. The cardstock is both the same, and I have to say, they are very, very thin. I usually don't mind this because I have to say they shuffle perfectly, but because they are so thin, I don't know how long they will last. Now, let's see the book for the Faeries Oracle, those cards here. There we go. First we have, of course, acknowledgement. Then we have the first steps into the other world, touching fairy, reading the cards, basic card spreads. And then we come to the part about the card meanings, and then preparing for a reading, reading the oracle for others, and then fairy style readings. There is a lot of information in this book already before you come to the card meanings, and you are encouraged not to read those meanings and first to make a few exercises that are pretty interesting. And first you should take a card that appeals to you the most, and then you should ask yourself a few questions. What is the emotional atmosphere of the card, or What might the physical manifestation of these card symbols be in someone's life, or what do you see in this what do you see in the card symbols that might represent the card's mental characteristics? What are the spiritual characteristics of the card, or what do you find most appealing about this card? And is there anything you find uncomfortable or unappealing about this card? And then you do the same again for a card that you don't like, or that you think it's uncomfortable or even frightens you a bit. And write everything down, what you have, write everything down. And then later you can look at what this card meaning is. But she really encourages you to find your own meanings, and I think this is quite important. Then we have a section about touching fairy and how to connect with fairy, singing with the fairies. So if you really want to connect with fairies and you don't know how, this is a really great, there are really great exercises and ideas how you can connect with the fairy realm and the fairies themselves. Then we also have card spreads, one card reading, and a three card reading. And with these cards, they are also meant to read reversals with. Then it talks also about the zero card. I didn't show you this one yet. Now, there you are encouraged to draw your own fairy guide. I haven't done this yet because, I'm not so good at this. But it represents your fairy guide and you make the own meaning of it. Then we start with, with the cards, and then you see the card Unity. And then we have a description of the being in the card. And then we have a starter reading and a reversed meaning. And then we go to the next cards. Again, a description of the card. Starter reading and reverse. So there is written a lot. And again, this is something you have to know if you like that or not. If you like a lot of information, you can get there are so many layers in that card because you have the description and the starter reading, and still, again, you are really encouraged to find your own meanings. But it's nice to have that background information. Something else is that those cards were chosen by the fairies themselves. So Jessica Macbeth writes about how she, how she contacted the fairies, or the fairies contacted her, and they worked together to find the right pictures or the images of Brian Froud to make this oracle. Here's another spread we have, and again another one. And there is really a lot of information in this book. So that's my doggy, sorry about that. For everybody who is interested in fairies, and not just the oracle itself, but really interested in connecting with fairies and the fairy realm, and who wants to know more about the beings in the card and more about the fairies, I would definitely recommend this book. The other book, The Heart of Faeries, I didn't mention it, but it's all hardcover, as you see, so that is really great. I love that. And here again, we start with how to use the cards, about the cards, and then we go into the meaning. And at the end, we still have an interview with Brian and Wendy Froud. And as you see, those beautiful pictures. Here we have the how to use the cards. And they talk about the morning exercise, the card of the day, but really do that not in stress, but to first think about what you have to do or what you should be doing. But just think about this moment when you are holding the cards in your hands. Now begin gently to shuffle the cards and then choose your card. And then again, they are also encouraging here to find your own meanings for the card. So here about the cards, they talk how they are divided in 7 groups. And each represents different aspects of fairy. And then we go into the card meaning. Hopala. So here, for example, the Queen of Passage. Then we have the keywords here, surrender, transition, trust. And this is the card meaning. So in the description, it talks a bit about the being in the card and the starter reading, so to say. But of course, if you compare this, this and then here. So this really depends on how you like to read. And I would say with this book, it is for a beginner, or I don't necessarily means a beginner, a card reader beginner, but if you are not so, I don't want to say comfortable, but if you are not so in contact with the fairy realm or whatever, this might be not so overwhelming. So here we have the interview. That is quite a few pages long. And here we also have a spread, because at first they only talk about a 1 card and a 3 card spread. And here we have the fairy the journey into fairy. And it goes like this around and out again. So then you have seen both books. And as I mentioned, it really depends how you like it. Now for the Heart of Faeries, we also have 3 cards with no description, with no meaning, and you have to find that out for yourself. On the other one, we have this card, and here we have those 3 cards. I show you a few cards now, and I just want to mention on both decks, the artwork is really gorgeous. So this is the Faeries Oracle, and we start with unity. The keywords are union, mystical experience, and spiritual home. Then we go to ecstasis, ecstasy, joy, rapture, motivation. The guardian at the gate, passages to new life, openings, gatekeeping. He of the fiery sword, active principle, spiritual will, justice, protection. Number 5. The keywords are the receptive principle, nurturing, and fertility. So these belong together. Then we have the singer of connection, with spiritual connection, karma, balance, and empathy. The singer of intuition, perceptiveness, oracular powers, awareness, trust. The singer of courage, bravery, sublimation of fear, moral strength. And then the singer of initiation, passage through trial, triumph, new level. Then the singer of healing. I don't know if you are able to read it, but sometimes with this deck I have trouble, because it is beautiful, fun, but it's sometimes hard to read. Healing body, mind, and spirit. Then number 11, the singer of transfiguration, transformation, transcendence, metamorphosis. And then the singer of chalice, trust, joy, patience, creativity, hope, miracles. And then solace, knowledge, consciousness, spiritual empowerment. And that were the singers. Then we have the maiden, birth, growth, joy, hope. And the journeyman with adventure, independence, polishing of skill and travel. The bright mother with creativity, nurturing, productivity, intimacy, sheltering. Then we have himself, natural law, life force, magic, shamanic power. Then we have the lady of the harvest with completion, grief, loss, harvest and release. Then we have the sage. Oh my god, I love this card so much. Wisdom, hidden knowledge, retreat, old age and patience. Oh my god, look at it. This is just an amazing card. And I'm rushing through this deck now so that it doesn't take forever, but I don't do it justice, you know. Now we have the Dark Lady with unconscious power and wisdom, rituals, mysteries and secret. Oh god, it's such a great card. The fairy who was kissed by the pixies. Love given, love received, and metaphorical open heart surgery. Just beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Then we have the master maker with skill, craftsmanship, magician, moral strength and invention. The green woman with wildness, natural magic, expectant gratitude, untrammeled creativity. Then we move on to the piper, music, order, harmony, seduction, empathy. And then we have the fairy godmother, gifts, talents, grace, helpful and helpful lessons. And oh, that gnome with trickster, creative chaos, wild gifts, breaking habits and patterns. And then Nellis the alchemist, inner transformation, irrevocable change. I had that last time in a reading. Very beautiful. Penelope Dreamweaver, inspirations, magical dreams, visions. And I think it's just stunning, but I cannot say it with every card because I kind of want to show them all with the keywords that you have an idea what they are about. Then we have, I don't know how to pronounce that, Ta-Om, the poet, Ta-Om. Clear sight, poetry, erotic energy, laughter, not getting into serious mischief. Then we have the loam, unconditional giving, unconditional receiving. And then undressing of a salad, balance, avoiding extremes, achieving the impossible, being impossible. So if you want to undress a salad dressing, so this is about achieving the impossible. Then we have Iris of the Rainbow, hope, promise for the future. And then we have the Faeries of the Future, and there we see how they go all in one direction except for one little fairy there. And this is be here now, guidance and moving forward. And then Sylvanus, truth, cutting through deception and clarity. And then we see more the artwork of the singers again. There we have the faun, about understanding the nature of nature, natural wisdom and natural magic. Then we go to the spirit dancer, self-expression, freedom, exploration. Then we have Tobira of the waters, emotion, serenity, meditation, graceful, accepting change. Leist, Leiste, Moon's daughter, light cast in the shadows, spiritual guidance, illumination and riddles. Then we have Los Guna with sunken treasures, discovery of self and adventure. Honesty, well, it's about honesty, compassion, tact and self-deceit. And then we have Ilbe, the retriever. Ilbe, I don't know how to pronounce all of them. Sorry about that. Office of unclaimed property, hopes and wishes, loyalty. So Mick, the myomancer. Small clues, details, the messages everywhere, patience. And then we have Geo, the slow. Cycles of time, slowness, waiting, patience. Then list of the shadows, healing the shadows, addiction, bondage, self-esteem. And we see clearly how she goes through the shadows here, through the dark, through the black, and she just holds her hand and we move through that now. I love it. Then we have Tating the Sylph. Acute intellect, quickness, mental synthesis, discernment. And the friends, friendship, support and aid. The Oakman with strength, ancient wisdom and depth. A collective of pixies with duty, willingness, joyful participation and virtue. So just like an example, how the description of the cards are: awareness of duty and a merry approach to it. The job has to be done. Do it willingly and with joy. Take joy and pride in achievement. This situation may take more than one person. Joining forces with others is appropriate at this time. See cooperation and friends, family, co-workers and fairies as appropriate. And with the reverse meaning, we would have: when pixies haven't enough to do, they tend to get into mischief together. Make sure that everyone involved knows what they are expected to do here and that they have enough work to keep them busy without being overloaded. Or, in different meaning for the reverse meaning, not getting the job done, promising and then not delivering. Help them to see the joy and satisfaction to be found in doing a good job cheerfully. Set a good example. Moving on to Mikkel and Mukkel. Everyday blessing, play and mixed blessings. And then we have Arvel Parrot, and this is all about communication. As you can see, he holds his finger through his throat chakra and we see the light there in the throat chakra. Then we have the topsy-turvet. As we can see here, it's not exactly the same, but it gives you the idea. Change of viewpoint, fresh looks, new ways of seeing. Then we have the Rar, wild energy, pure potential. Then we have Death, with natural, timely endings, release, liberation. Epona's wild daughter, with inner shadows, nightmare, depression, madness and growth. And then the Soul Shrinker, cruelty, malice, gossip, curses, destruction and blessing. And then the gloomiest doom, self-defeat, self-pity, self-destruction, taking care of ourselves. Next card, Luathas the Wild, haste, impulsiveness, fire, spontaneity and balance. Then we have Vijfde Voeten, being real, earthing, grounding and centering. And in the book it talks a lot about how you can give yourself foot massages and, you know, that you feel your feet again, and that whenever you have holes in your socks, that the Vijfde Voeten is there to tell you that you are not grounded. Then we have number 59 with meddling, tampering, sabotage, helpful fixer and order. Then the Pook, shape changer, good in bad, bad in good, paradox and resolution. Then we have G.Hobbia, imaginary fears, unreal hazards, realistic caution. Then number 62 with illusion, delusion, lust, projection and clear sight. And then Indy with indecision, wishy-washy, commitment, decision making. Then 64 with gotcha, sudden shock, unexpected events, rude awakenings. And the last card, the Felion, getting it right, or the Felion, sorry. Getting it right, delayed completions and tidying up loose ends. So those are all the cards for the Faeries Oracle, that you have an idea, you know, first of all, but I can't talk about them all because I just want to show them to you. As you see, I have with the light it's a bit, yeah, but I have etched them gold and copper, so it's nice when it's mixed up, but now it's in order. Maybe I will change it to all copper, I don't know yet. Let's see the other cards, a quick walkthrough. And here we start with card number 1 with support, so healing and equilibrium. Then we have the Queen of Bedlam with responsibilities of partnership, frustration and gift of sanity. And just to give you an example of how it is written here. She is an everyday queen, a queen of day-to-day life, the keeper of the little things that when added together becomes a madness of sorts. Have you ever been doing something very ordinary? Something that you have done 1,000 times when suddenly it seems that if you do this particular thing one more time, you will go mad. It could be as simple as packing your children's lunch boxes, sewing a button on your partner's trousers again, or cleaning up a mess your dog just made. These are all the responsibilities of partnership that must be dealt with over and over again. When the feeling of I'm going mad sweeps over you at these times, the Queen of Bedlam has decided to visit. She is calmly sitting in your kitchen, pulling the petals of the flower in the vase on the table. She's tearing your kitchen sponge into tiny pieces and cutting the sleeves off your partner's shirt. She's doing this for you. She comes to take the feelings of total frustration, of just not being able to continue living with any sanity at all, and envelops them in her immense capacity to embrace everyday madness. It is her reason for existing, so give generously of your small neuroses. She take care of them and leave you sane to face another day. Well, that's the description for this card. Then you have an idea how this sounds. Then we have the Queen of the Night with desire, yearning and inspiration. The number 4, the Queen of the Day, grace, beauty and blessing. Number 5, and I'm messing it up here, with surrender, transition and trust. Number 6, the Queen of Owls, physical healing, wholeness, wellness. Then the Queen of Hearth, and Home. Welcome, courtesy, graciousness. The Queen of Shadows, introspection, acknowledgement, and balance. The next one, the Queen of Laughter, Art of Joy, Lightness, and Fun. And again, a card that I really, really love because she really looks so happy and so... there we go. Can you see clearly her face? I love absolutely her face. Then we have the next card with the Captive Man, False Perceptions, Enthrallment, Release from Captivity. The Prince of Shadows, Danger, Addiction, and Irresistible Urge. So he is the one you can take as a fairy lover, but will leave you brokenhearted, with a broken heart. Then we have the Prince of Light, with New Beginnings, Peacemaker Potential. The Speaker of Truth, Trust, Acceptance, Open Heart. The next card is the Shapeshifter, with Perception, Illusion, Truth Within. Then we have the Elven Knight, Enchantment, Call of Faerie, and Leadership. Then we have the Messenger, Confusion, Mischief, Gossip. And the Rocks, Manipulation, Neediness, Make an Effort. And yeah, you can see it in his face how he is somebody who, you know, he's needy. And it says here, the poor rocks always ill, sniffles, aches and pain, a slight temperature. He just can't gather the energy to help himself, but he always have enough energy to get you to help him. And for me, this is very clear in this card. Then the next card, the Thief, excuses, inaction, lessons to learn. And we go to the archetypes. And we have here the Lord of the Forest, Eternal Masculine, Action and Strength. Then of course we also have the Lady of the Forest with Eternal Feminine, Dreaming and Feeling. So those two together are really nice. Then the next one is the Boy with Adventure, Freedom and Youth. And then we have the Maiden, First Love, Wonder, Endless Possibilities. Then the Heartless Love with Abandonment, Heartbreak, False Expectations. The Child, Pure Joy, Sense of Wonder Without Judgment. And this is so, again, such a pretty card. Because when you look at it in the back here, this being who watches over the child, you know, and they both look at this light, whatever it is. And yeah, I just really, really like this card. Then we have the Hero, which talks about strength, courage, and unconditional love. So the Hero we see here more of, you know, think of love for the earth, think of love that let us accept the differences in people and the beliefs around us, and think of love that is truly unconditional. So, and that is heroism. That is the single thing that truly overcomes obstacles in our world and in fairy. Then we have the Crone. Look again, wise woman and direction. And first she looks a bit scary, but when we turn around we see the other face. Really love that in the cards. We have sometimes those things in both stacks where when you turn the card around, you see something different. Then we have the Sorcerer with interesting help, true magic and consequences. The Magician, fairy glamour, responsibility and illusion. Then we have the Green Man and of course also the Green Woman. That's nice as well. And then the Smith as the last one of the archetypes, I think, yeah. Bond, promises and creation. And then when we think about the Smith, with, you know, when he makes rings about a bond and a promise. And there's so much to see in those cards. And then we go into the group of sprites. And there we have the Fairy of Youth, enthusiasm, limitless ability and positive expectations. Oops. And then we have the Fairy of Growth with movement, growth, revisioning process. And then we have Tink, independence, freedom of expression, standing your ground. The next one is Bright Spark, understanding, illumination, idea. Then we have the Star Fairy, universal connections, cosmic collaboration, unity. And this reminds me then again more of the artwork here, what we had with the singers. But we still see more of a figure in here. Well, she is clearly a fairy here. It is not so clear. It's just energy, you know. Then we have the Fairy of Naughtiness, lightener, mischief, misrule. And she's sticking out her tongue. Can you see? Then the next card is the Pan. And there we have Joyous Flight, Courage, the Big Thing. Then we have the Fixer, Whitewashing, Self-Deception, Best Intentions. Yeah, you know, somebody who wants to clean up that, you know, that everything seems fine, and we see him here with a broom and he tries to, yeah, it should all look nice, you know. And then we go into the group of the ladies. Clear sight, foreknowledge, fairy gifts. The Lady of Unicorns, belief, magical connection and guardianship. The Lady of Song with listening, stillness and harmony. We can see how she listens with her big ears. The Lady of Sorrows, lack of forgiveness, barriers, letting go. Then we have the Lady of Faith, believe in oneself, brave heart, fortitude. The Lady of Joy, joy in the moment, sharing, true gift. And then we go to the Tricksters, and the first card there is the Juggler. I try to find a keyword, sorry. So, scattered attention, reassessment, priorities. The Big Behind, new perspective, knowing your options, survival. Prick up your ears, jumping to conclusions, listening with clarity, appropriate meaning. Very important, you know. And then we have, oh no, just one of those days, obstructions, the unexpected. The next one is the Hidden One, awareness, attention, self-absorption. Then into Minds, internal dialogue, decision, action. Great card again. Well, I love them all anyway. And then the next card is the Paradox. We come now into... No, not yet. So the Paradox, resolution of opposites, intuitive decision, tricky situation. And again, when we turn the card, we have a different face. Ta-da! Now we come to the last group of cards, and there we have the Journey. And the first card here is the Blessing. Blessings of the day, journey beginnings. Then we have the Leaving, moving forward, order, directions. Then the Remembrance, with lessons learned, important memories, heart connection. Then the Challenge, self-criticism, obstruction, go for it. The Joy of the future, fearful anticipation, optimism, the now. The Shadow of the past, past love, letting go, resolution. Then we have the Song, attentive awareness, hidden energy, listen with your heart. The Question, intention, dialogue, answers. The next card, the Temptation, with enticement, wise choices, safety. The Hope, light in the dark, faith and comfort. Dreaming, creative thoughts, imagination, permission to dream. The Gift, wisdom, gracious, acceptance and recognition. And the last card with the Returning, profound change, new perspective and understanding. So in both decks we have reversible backs, but the intention, oops, and I switched that. The intention of this book is, or of this deck, is not to read with reversed cards. They also say, of course, you can, nobody can, you know, say what you do, but they go more from, the card means what they means, but in both, you have the opportunity to do that with both decks or not, whatever you choose. Now, when I have to compare those two decks, it is really a bit difficult, but in general, I think that the energy here is a bit more raw, and this is a bit more polished. So, exactly. I have two crystals with me. This is, you know, a raw crystal. This fits to this deck, and here we have a polished one. And this fits here. Both are beautiful, both works fine, but it's just what you prefer. And I am really happy to have both, because I read with them both. I have read more with this deck. I'm not sure why. There is not really a reason behind it. This talks about also life and relationships. So this is often mentioned as a deck who is good for relationships. But this means not necessarily romantic relationships, but relationships with everything, you know, with friends, with family, with nature, with fairies, with yourself, you know. So you can read those cards as well for every single theme, really. So I think it's really, really difficult to make a choice there. And I think, as I mentioned already, I would say if you are really interested in fairies and what the fairy beings are, and if you are comfortable with reading about fairy channeling, so to say, this is a great book. if you say, I just start working with fairies, or I don't even necessarily want to work with fairies, I just want the oracle, I would go for this one, I think. But it's really a hard decision. I'm happy to have both. And of course you can work with them together. You can mix them up. Well, it's a bit of a, you know, shuffling challenge, but it works. I did a reading with both decks 2 days ago, and it works really fine, and they really complete each other, I want to say. Well, this is just a personal impression, but I think this is a bit, yeah, when I talk about that this is raw, this has a more gentle voice. Not that it's wishy-washy, but or doesn't want to say the truth, but it has a more nurturing and gentler voice for me personally. Yeah, and there we have the more raw energies. I cannot say that here the beings are older, or that there is more ancient wisdom in it. That is for me the same, really. Of course, we have other beings. Here we have queens and what is more structured. And in the other one we have, yeah, of course, the more raw energies and the more, but still, both stacks are equally valuable. I think with this book it is easier to come in, because this could be overwhelming for somebody who does not work with fairies or with the fairy realm so much. Then this book comes more to the point immediately. And again, both stacks invite you to work more intuitively with it. Even when I did the deck interviews, it was like, yeah, you know, if you want to work with me, read me intuitively. What, you're going to the book now? No, 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 no. So I really like that. However, I hope that this was somehow helpful. And if you want more information, or I should do something else, or, you know, because it's kind of difficult to bring everything in into one video now and to do that quick walkthrough. But I just want you to see all the cards, because that's what I like when I choose to buy something, or before I buy something, I want to see every single card and see if it resonates with me. And I think giving you the keywords with that, you have an idea what this card is about, actually. Well, I think that's it. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'm happy, really happy to answer, because I think it's really difficult to say which deck is for what, because this is a very personal choice. But I think you can, you know, choose between the guidebooks. Too much information, you know, sometimes it can be too much information. I'm great with that. I love that. But, yeah, if you start, maybe less would be better. I don't know. However, thank you very much for watching. I'm always happy. And, yeah, please let me know if you want to know anything. And, yeah, that's it. Yes, I go just bye. Bye-bye.